wanna see a dead body?
Right, so I've got a box today, and I'm reasonably sure what it is. If it's not what I think it is, it's something even better, but...
Instrumentals from my mama's Christmas party. Troubles on my mind. I still smell crime. My little brother crying.
So, I know what you're asking. Who in the right mind orders three Ninja Turtle figures? There's a story behind that. I've been buying a lot of turtle figures recently. And as a result of that, I followed NECA, who make the Turtles figures, on Instagram. And they did a post over there saying, we're going to do some double packs of the movie versions from the 90s. I was looking at them, and all of a sudden I just got hit by this massive wave of nostalgia. And I was like, oh. So without really thinking about it, I went on Zavvi, which is where I get all my Turtles figures from. And they had them in for pre-order. So I thought, right, I'll pre-order them. And then... by the end of the month, I can decide whether this is just like a momentary kind of or if I really wanted them. So I went online thinking I've cancelled them. But what I actually apparently had done is just cancelled one of the figures off the order. So the day after, I woke up to a dispatch notification saying your order's been sent. You've got 3 out of 4 Turtles figures on the way. So this is going to be like a part one of two. And in the second part, I'm going to unbox Leonardo and show you the rest of them. But check these out, man.
I like turtles.
Right, cool. I'm gonna go online now, order Leonardo, because I f***ed out, and then when that comes, I'll finish this off. Thanks.
It's exactly 11 o'clock and I'm just nipping downstairs to get this second parcel that's just arrived, which is my follow-up order to my Ninja Turtles.
Mate, you're right. I think you might have a parcel for me.
Alright, cool. You okay?
Yeah, you?
Yeah, good.
Oh, two of them.
Thanks a lot, mate. Cheers for that.
See ya.
Oh, f***. You ain't got your card on here, I forgot. I'm upstairs, sorry.
My f***ing door pass. Didn't ask her to let me through the door. Bye-bye.
Are you expecting anything?
I don't know what it is.
Do you want me to put it with your other presents?
Yes, please. Will you wrap it up?
No, fuck off. Wrapping other people's presents for you? You think I am some sort of fucking mug?
So, I've just been to collect my second Turtles delivery of the week, the Leonardo one that I told you about in the previous video. And in the space in between those others arriving and this one coming, I've been thinking a lot about, like, why I buy these. And I thought... what did I think? So in 1913, Marcel Proust wrote a book. I'm not going to try and pronounce the French name for it.
À la recherche du temps perdu.
It's the longest novel that's ever been written. It's twice the length of War and Peace, and it's regarded as one of the best novels of the century, so basically ever. And a famous scene from this book was the Madeleine scene, where he sat drinking tea and eating Madeleine. He puts a little crumb on a teaspoon and he eats it. And all of a sudden, out of nowhere, he gets this sensation of when he was a child. He doesn't know what it is. So he tries to recreate it and he drinks some more of the tea and he eats some more of the cake. It's not working. When he dips the cake into the tea and he eats it, he gets this feeling again wash over him, and he realises that when he was a little kid, his aunt used to dip the Madeleine into the tea and give it to him, and he'd lock this little memory away in his head until he was an adult. Never thought about it again. But when he had the same combination of tea and Madeleine, it transported him back to this sort of touch point in his life, and he was immediately a child again. Sidebar, he's referenced in a lot of films, namely Ratatouille. The scene at the end where he eats the ratatouille and is transported back to a kid, that's a clear reference. And also in the Jason Statham film The Transporter. So this film just stops in its tracks halfway through and delivers Proust's theory on memory via the same metaphor that they do in the book, which for a film like that, with scenes like this in... although it is directed by Luc Besson, so he's a bit of a character. Anyway, let's open this. Oh, put You say that? They know full well that these are like limited edition and that they're selling them to collectors, and then they put f***ing stickers on the front of them. They did this with one of the two packs as well. I had to peel it off the front as carefully as I possibly could. The most vivid memory I've got of being a kid was after 2 or 3 weeks of looking around every possible toy shop during the height of Turtle Mania. We went to a mall fairly late at night. I remember it being like dark for some reason. And my parents were off looking at something, and I kind of wandered off to a shop. I wandered in and there was a total full wall of every Ninja Turtle figure that was out at that moment. And if you've ever seen the Ninja Turtle boxes, I'm sure you haven't. Because you're not a nerd. They've got a very particular design. It's like a brick wall, and then you usually got a repeating pattern of whatever character it is. The whole wall was just this repeated. Boom, boom, boom. Every turtle figure, every baddie, every like incidental character that they just created to make a figure out of. And I remember just being stood there, basking in the most amazing thing I've ever seen. And when I see that old turtle packaging, I'm immediately transported back to that moment just for a second. There's an amazing scene in Ghost Story that kind of helps you understand what I'm trying to say, in that you can be in one place in time with an object, and you can almost touch another point in time through that same object. There's a scene in Ghost Story where he's died and she's listening to a song, and through the edit it shows that the moment in time when she's listening to it for the first time after he's just written it, and a moment in time where she's listening to it laid on the floor after he's been dead for a while, the hem of his ghost cloak just brushes her fingers. And through like that sort of understanding of time, you can see that they're kind of interacting in these two different places at the same time through this one object, which is the tape cassette or like the music. Really interesting. I promise myself, when I'm a millionaire, I'm going to go online, I'm going to buy one of each pristine packaged Turtles figure with the holes punched in the cards, and I'm going to make a wall in a room just like in that shop. I'm going to hang one of each figure on that wall, and then when I'm down or uninspired, I'm just going to walk into that room and stand in front of it and feel like a six-year-old kid again. And that's the aim. And the only way I can go about doing that is either win the lottery or become very successful. So I pray for the first one and plan for the second one, right? But yeah, that's it. That's a long way of saying that Ninja Turtle figures are my Madeleines. Look into Marcel Proust, watch Ratatouille, watch The Transporter, definitely watch Ghost Story. And watch Ninja Turtles, a movie. First and the second one are really good. They're not, but they are. Like and subscribe, all that bollocks.